I'm Jack Bufton. I'm a fourth year pharm chem student at the Leslie Down Faculty of Pharmacy, and I'm currently doing research in Dr. Christine Allen's lab. My lab is focused on nanomedicine for oncology. Nanoparticles around 50 to 200 nanometers tend to accumulate in tumor tissue, preferentially over normal tissue. And therefore, if you load a drug into that particle, you can actually have the drug being released essentially within the tumor, and that will lead to a decrease in side effects from these chemotherapeutic drugs and an increase in efficacy. But a lot of the problem is, to make a nanomedicine, there's a lot more considerations you have to take into account. And a lot of that is just making your particles. My project was microfluidic production of nanoparticles. And microfluidics is the manipulation of fluids at tiny, tiny levels. To make a device that is capable of doing that, you need specialized equipment, you need software and hardware to drive that equipment. So I phoned up a couple of microfluidic companies and asked them for quotes, and one of the quotes I got was around $70,000 for one of these systems. And I was like, that's great, but we don't have that much money, and especially for an undergrad project, I'm never going to get funded. So therefore I thought, let's break the device down into its components. You have a chip, which is the main star of the device. It's where the mixing and all the cool microfluidic stuff happens. And then the rest of it is essentially a pumping mechanism. And I actually thought, well, that I can actually do myself. And luckily I'd actually had some contact with Dr. David Dubins, and he had introduced me to electronics and the whole idea that you can actually make devices and program stuff, and you can combine that with 3D printing and laser cutting to make prototypes yourself cheaply. So the reason why I think this is applicable is my device will hopefully allow you to shorten time so we can actually get to preclinical trials and get data faster so we can develop formulations faster.